For those stations not taking a pledge break, we have a story about a prison project that offers benefits for inmates and the environment. It's part of our series, NewsHour Connect. Tonight's story comes from Jule Gilfillan of Oregon Public Broadcasting.
They're pretty fast.
There we go.
Harry Greer is raising endangered Oregon spotted frogs for release back into the wild.
See the spots? The biggest ones that we had last year were 58 grams.
But Harry's not a professional, and these fat, healthy frogs are not the only ones waiting for release.
I'm here on a robbery beef. I have 18 months, 10 days, and a wake-up. I'm done.
This is the Cedar Creek Correctional Center near Olympia.
How often are you guys testing the water quality?
The frog-rearing program here pairs inmates with scientists from the Evergreen State College as part of the Sustainable Prisons Project. So far, the frogs grown at Cedar Creek are doing better than those grown by professional zoologists.
They have a lot more time here to care for the frogs that a zoo wouldn't have. I mean, they're here all day with them, so they change the water frequently. They feed them more frequently than a zoo could ever do.
Morning, guys. How you doing?
Dan Pacholke was superintendent at Cedar Creek back in 2003. At that time, Dan needed to expand the inmate capacity, but his water treatment plant was maxed out.
We decided to reduce consumption and started working on water conservation measures. And along the way, I met Melini Nadkarni, who's a professor and faculty of the Evergreen State College.
After hearing about the issue, Nalini arranged for a scientist to teach the prison's staff and inmates about water conservation.
And I saw the men responding in such a positive way. So I began inviting my colleagues to come and give talks about their own areas of science. Some of those lectures inspired action. So the next trip I came out here, you know, lawn had been ripped up and there was this fabulous organic garden. That turned into composting. We then started worm composting. We started recycling. We started water catchment bases.
Before long, Cedar Creek's inmates were scraping their trays instead of washing food waste down the drain and processing compost for use as fertilizer in vegetable gardens. What started off as water conservation quickly became a full-circle green culture, and the Sustainable Prisons Project was born. The project was also good for Cedar Creek's bottom line.
It absolutely saves money. It saves money every way that it can be saved. Our garbage bill went down by about $500 a month. Our water use rate started to drop. The amount of total suspended solids down in our sewage treatment plant was dropping off tremendously, which meant we didn't have to do a $1.4 million expansion.
After 5 years, the benefits of sustainable practices were paying off in a big way.
It was at that point I think Dan and I realized we had something special here. And it was at that point that I said, you know, I think there are other larger scale science and conservation projects that we could bring into this.
That's when Cedar Creek began an experimental program to see if offenders there could grow frogs for a new partner, the U.S. Army.
This is Daleman Lake, the reintroduction site for the Oregon spotted frog. This is where all the frogs grown at Cedar Creek and the other facilities, the other zoos, have been released.
Jim Lynch is a fish and wildlife biologist at Joint Base Lewis McChord, a vast facility that covers some 200 square miles.
We've released for 2 years now, and each year there have been approximately 500 frogs released.
So far, the frogs seem to be doing well, but they're just one of many species the Army hopes to restore.
The goal is to restore 20,000 acres of habitat to high-quality native prairie.
To take on the monumental restoration task, the Army turned to the Sustainable Prisons Project and to the Stafford Creek Correctional Center in Aberdeen, which houses 2,000 inmates.
The first year we did about 120,000 of 9 different species. This year we're doing near 400,000 of 13 different species.
Stafford Creek inmate Toby Earhart is growing prairie grasses for the Lewis McChord restoration with the help of Evergreen graduate student Carl Elliott.
So the training is basic horticulture techniques. And I spent a lot of time teaching them sensitivity and observation. I want them to be able to observe what they see and be sensitive to changes in the plants or insects that they may see affecting them.
And that's why they're good for the insects, because
the time these inmates have for observation and record keeping also results in valuable scientific data.
There's virtually no science on the germination or growth of these species because they are wild and no one has cultivated them for profit, so there's no mass sowing information on them.
The program may be without a profit motive, but there's plenty of motivation.
I mean, I came to a prison thinking it was going to be so tough and so hard to break through to these guys with bald heads and tattooed. And they've been the easiest. They've been the ones who have accepted and wanted more than any other audience I've ever worked with.
The scientific aspect of this project has been pretty much new to me. I had never even heard of any of these things. These are called lomatium that we're planting right now. These ones, Areophyllum lanatum. You know, I'm learning Latin, for goodness sakes. You know, lanatum means to provide with wool or covered with wool.
In addition to educational and scientific benefits, there also seems to be a social upside.
What I've seen is that their stress levels go down and their fear levels go down, their aggression levels go down. It's a hard thing to measure in a prison, but we have some deep sense of that in each one of the prisons that we're working in and each type of the projects that we're working as well.
They begin to work as a team much better. Oftentimes that's not how things work socially among offenders. And slowly but surely that's happening.
The partnerships formed by the project seem likely to continue, even if the relationship Harry Greer has formed with several dozen Oregon spotted frogs will be over in a few months.
I'm happy to see them go, you know what I mean? Because they're being set free, which my turn's coming too. I'm rooting for them. I want to see them live and produce and bring back what we worked for.
You can see an extended version of that story by following a link on our website.